All right, we're running.
Thank you.
You just move this just a little bit. Just got him out of here. Perfect. Like that. Like that. Perfect.
Doing Pavan by Gabrielle Aure.
Unfortunately, you're gonna have to be my unofficial, you know, AV guy. Is it still me? Thank you.
So as each group is breaking down, setting up, and we're gonna have a changeover to be very quick. We were very lucky to have two interns, college interns with us this year. Okay, one of them you're about to see, Mark Jones, is going to conduct the next piece. And the other one is Madison Cutler, who unfortunately is not with us. For good reasons, though. She had a big wedding to go to. Not her own, but she had a big wedding to go to. And she'll be with us on Monday conducting the students. You know, we're very thankful to have them with us. And Mark is currently at Ithaca.
Yep.
Finishing his study of music education.
Yep.
So, again, we'll thank you.
One more thing, parents, we are recording the concert, so if you just, you know, just focus on the music, don't worry about recording the child, we'll make the videos available sometime next week, okay? Thank you.
Benjamin and Anderson on first clarinet.
we switch over to our next group, we want to thank New York Phil for supporting this program. Gina, it's hard to see, but I know you're back there somewhere, okay. So Gina, New York Phil, you're there, thank you so much. Okay. So with their partnership, we were able to go, it was like 2 weeks ago, we were able to go see a string quartet rehearse over the Rose Building across the street. Okay. And then certainly we have Justin Hines, who's been working with the students. Earlier we had Scott, who was working with us for the first couple of days. Both of them are fantastic, and we're very thankful that not only did he get to work with the percussionists, but he's also been working with all the students. Yesterday he gave a wonderful lesson on the opera, opera ballet. We saw Romeo and Juliet the other day. So at this time, we'll introduce our percussionists.
Christopher Fellinger, and he was saxophone ensemble, Sax Appeal. We will be playing the Can Can by Jacques Offenbach and Satin Doll by Duke Ellington. On Barry Sax, we have Mario. On Tenor Sax, we have Lewis and Anthony. On Alto Saxophone 2, we have Bowie and Thomas. On Alto 1, I have myself, Jet, and Miles.
Thank you.
group is setting up, which will be our last group, and this is kind of like in my head, I'm a little jumbled up because it's a little unexpected today, so forgive me, but I just want to take a moment to recognize that that unfortunately, Tony Bennett, we got word that Tony Bennett passed away last night, and Tony Bennett has played over the years a huge role in this program. He is the founder of Frank Sinatra High School, the school that we are in over the summer. You know, when the school first started, they were in a warehouse, and he's the one that advocated to get the building that they're in now. This program started as an offshoot of 9/11. We were at Stuyvesant for a number of years, and he didn't want his building, meaning Tony Bennett, didn't want Frank Sinatra empty during the summer, and he played a key role to have us move from Stuyvesant High School to where we are now. Not only did he support the program financially, but he would visit, he would spend time with the students during the summer, you know, out of his busy schedule when he was able. And what do we say, Mr. Lopez, he's going to turn 97 next week?
Yeah, week and a half.
Yeah, so the program used to be a week later, and a week later, and Mr. Bennett spent a number of his birthdays with us at the school, including at performances. He went a number of years, he didn't miss any performances. So, you know, definitely a loss for the music community, certainly a loss for the Frank Sinatra High School community, and as well as SAR, I mean, there's no doubt. So in the last few years, he hasn't been able to join us, but, you know, to give you an example where his heart was, when he turned 90, I don't know if you remember, Lady Gaga and he did a concert together, and it was during his birthday, and he wanted the students from SAI to be the audience members. So back when that happened, our students were the members of that concert. If you Google it and you look back at it. So, you know, he definitely had his heart with young students musically, no doubt. All right, so, you know, our thoughts from SAI are with Ms. Bendetto, his wife, Susan Bendetto, and the rest of his family, and, you know, our thoughts and prayers.
Thank you.
this is the future. This is what's going to help make sure that the arts are still thriving in the next 20, 30 years. Thank you again.
So I got one other thing for you, which I totally forgot about. I don't even know if it happened or where. So we came out of the building on our way here, and the news crews were outside school filming, of course, look what happened to Mrs. Bennett. And as soon as they saw the students pouring out of the building, the cameras went up. So you may want to check out the news later, and you might see them coming out. One reporter was like, quick, 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 and he's like speaking as they're passing by, you know, making sure they all got in the shot. I'm sorry, I don't know what channels they were, but at least two did film the group. So you may want to check that out later on the news.
The driver was from Egypt, and his family was Coptic.